The scariest thing I've experienced lately is dogs. I never used to be afraid of dogs, and then I lived in this building, this apartment building, that made me scared of all dogs now forever, because it was like weird immersion therapy. It was like I was supposed to be scared of dogs, and I wasn't, and somebody wanted to get me there. Like, no, you're supposed to be scared of dogs. I know what to do. I'll put you in this crazy-ass building where everybody has an insane, vicious dog but you. That's what it was like. Everybody in this building, it was like I missed a memo in the common area or something where it's like, let's all get crazy dogs. If you don't want to get one, check this box. And then I never saw that memo. Every day this happened, every day, I would be walking down the stairs from my apartment. And just as I was kind of like, you know, thinking, what is today going to hold for me? I would like turn the corner on the landing and then, dog out of nowhere barking. So angry at me. Why is he so mad at me? So mad. And it's like, well, what happened was I would, of course, jump, you know, and then I'll be perfectly honest with you. Sometimes I would make a noise of some sort. Like I would jump and go, like that. What drove me crazy was the person whose dog it is, the person standing there on the other end of this leash, right? They would not apologize for the dog for what just happened. Like, they saw it happen. It's not like it was subtle, right? It's not like they were looking away like, oh, what's happening? Are you guys talking? We're not talking. This dog wants to have my face in his mouth. Never an apology. And it's not like I didn't give them the in for the apology either. I mean, I tossed them some nice fat softballs. You know what I'm saying? I made it easy. Just something like, wow. He certainly gave me quite a start, that dog that is your responsibility. Man, oh man. Whew, trying to catch my breath here. Oh, really scared me there. Me, a fellow human being with feelings and dignity. Whew, it's like I saw my life flash before my eyes. Oh, man. I was so scared. I mean, I'm sure that the dog would apologize if he could, but as he lacks the capacity for speech, I wonder who will pick up the baton. Oh, of the three of us, who here is best equipped to apologize for what your dog has done? He's a dog, he's out. I am the person who was scared. Doesn't make any sense, really, for me to do that. Oh, what do your calculations tell you? Because I'm out of people. Nothing. Every once in a while, though, I would get this, which was even worse than nothing. People would say this, super condescending. Like the dog barks, I'm scared. And then the person goes, he's all right. Really condescending like that. Now look, I don't think he's all right. Because my definition of all right never includes fangs. Never. Not once has that ever happened. I'm not saying I've been called upon to define all right that many times in my life. But if you woke me out of a sound sleep, Paul, what does the concept of all right entail? I would not go, it starts with fangs. That would not, that scenario would not happen. I don't think he's all right. I think he's trying to strain at that thin cord of a leash. So he wants to get a taste of my sweet neck blood, which once he eats, he will never want anything else again. Yeah, I'm on to you, dogs. And all your secrets! Now look, I know you don't want to apologize for your dog because he's your pal, right? Dog's your buddy! It's like he's not even a dog anymore and you're not even a human. You are just friends. Well, let's say you had a human friend and you and your human friend were at a bar someplace and a stranger walked into the bar. And your human friend turned to the stranger and said, I am going to murder you! I don't think you would say, he's all right. He's more scared of you than you are of him. I don't think so. Said he was gonna murder me. I think I'm winning the scared contest. Why would that bar have that contest? Who would go there? Scared contest. Sign up at 8 o'clock. Contest starts at 9. I'll cut that part out. All right. I can if I want. Cut this part out where I'm talking about it.